Mayhap 'tis time we met with this Lord Phasis. Shall we make for Moonglen Tower? Follow me, Master. I shall guide you to the location.
A ballista is a ranged weapon.
This could grant us an edge in battle.
'Tis a hobgoblin!
We have no means of exploiting our enemy's weakness.
Power surges within me. Our foe has been knocked off balance. Grab hold and drag it to the ground. Strike fast and true, and our quarry shall fall. There's a ladder here.
We ought to put it to good use. Mayhap 'tis time we met with this Lord Phasis. Shall we make for Moonglen Tower? Follow me, Master. I shall guide you to the location.
I will protect you. Get ahead of ourselves. The battle continues.
That was certainly worthwhile.
Ah. Here we go again. We fight. To arms.
Understood.
Methinks these climbs are ill-suited to them. It's a lonely place to be sure. I shall remain by your side. A flawless execution.
Let us try for the same result with our next attack.
Formidable arisen.
This oxcart has been destroyed.
Wrought by the hands of brigands. Or the claws of monsters.
Careful now!
It would seem the stone puppet has stopped. Have the wounded been tended to?
Yes, my lord.
Good. I trust you are prepared, Sovereign of Vermund.
Will it really be all right? I'm not about to be charred, am I?
Fear not. You are in no danger. The dragon shall be under my control. When it appears. Come. Let us press onward.
Beg pardon if my hospitality is a bit lacking, sir. My duties tending to the excavation tools take up most of my time. But if you seek a bed and you've the coin, 'tis yours. No questions asked.
We must rest, though the sun is still up.
I return safe and sound. And I dare say, wiser for my travels. I feel refreshed and ready for a new day.
Come, we've much to be getting on with.
Feeling rested, I trust?
Wow,
What is it? Has something happened? You ought at least rest for the evening. There should be a spare bed in the lodgings yonder. Only don't go rushing off before you're ready. Take it from me. You're better off resting while you have the chance.
What purpose does this contraption serve? Perhaps you might investigate, Arisen.
We pawns will be ready to respond, whatever the outcome.
Dragon, heed my call. Your will is mine to command. Curses. This arrival of the true Risen is most inopportune. Sovereign of Vermin, the ritual must not be disturbed. Let not the Arisen approach. You can manage that, I trust.
It is of vital import that we have a word with your Curses. The pretender need not be present.
Efforts are for naught, Arisen. Now, simply watch as this world's hollow and fruitless order is remade by my hand. The ritual is complete. The dragon comes. my power, the dogma of dragons is unmade.
You could ne'er understand, Arisen.
We must all be freed from the vulgar order wherein the dragon's existence determines all.
Hast thou summoned the resolution to face me? Then answer me this. Why dost thou fight? Is it to reclaim thy flesh, thy stolen heart? Or is it to reclaim thy throne? I offer thee a choice. Grant unto me this life in my claws, and be gone from this place. Or stand and fight. Pitiable Arisen. The time for thou to make thy choice is come. Show me the path thou wouldst walk. Go, and thou shalt live to claim thy coveted throne. Charges. I as the dragon, and thou as the Arisen. Climb upon me. We shall depart for our true battlefield.
Close paths before.
Thou art too late. The hour is upon us. We must decide a victor. And in so doing, form a link in the chain that bind at this wheel. Tell me, Arisen, what is thy desire?
Why do you pursue me, Arisen? You have fulfilled your charge. Are you not satisfied? Seek you greater status? Perhaps to rule the world entire? It is power you desire. You need merely spy out the path.
The choice is thine, Arisen. By thy will alone can the course of the winners of fate be altered.
You would still resist your fate. Understand you the folly of such a decision. Even the beating of your reclaimed heart was born of the great will of this world. Yet you would abandon it. Everything in this world, all that you have come to know as reality, is the creation of the Great Will. Should that will be lost, no mortal being can survive. However, if regret yet assails your spirit, then perhaps you should reaffirm your choice. Witness with your own eyes, or through the eyes of another, the fate of this world.
Thou wishest to dismantle the world's will, just as I do. Yet dost thou know what awaiteth the world, should it meet such a fate? Would become fated, fragile, vacuous thing, bereft of the cycle. Naught would be born into it save chaos, great and terrible. Surviving in such a world,
turn back.
Leave now, while you can.
You have strayed, Arisen. And for what? Lest you forget. You have a world where you belong. There, you are to fell the great evil in your path and rule the people as their sovereign. For that is who you are. And it is my wish that you should live out that life of purpose. The time has come for you to return. Go. My children shall see you there safely.
Let us go home, together.
To a world under your rightful rule.
To a world all your own.
This is your will? Then behold, a world unmerciful, bereft of the benevolent hands of darkness. You find it strange, but this is your world, the world to which you longed to return. Alas, if only you had chosen to become sovereign. At the end of your travails, you could have ruled over these lands in perpetual peace. Yet that world of limitless possibilities has ended. You stand now upon its remains, the vestiges of a world that could have been so much more. Innumerable wills have served to deliver this world from extinction time and time again. You alone have refused to carry out that great purpose. What you see before you is the consequence of your apathy. Behold. As it has failed to be chosen, and as 'twill ne'er be read, this world will soon cease to exist. In the blink of an eye, the sickle of oblivion will reap aught that you have known. I would advise you not to waste these last moments. Explore the remnants of this world while you can. Perhaps, in doing so, you shall come to see the truth. And know the wretchedness of a world unworthy of being chronicled. How shall you fare, I wonder? Will you endure in this world, abandoned and unprotected?
This outcome was unknown to me. I had not thought it possible.
Truly?
Since times of eld, dragon blood has been used to refine all manner of equipment. I myself learned the art by deciphering ancient texts. Remember, draconic blood flows through the veins of lesser drakes as well. Bring me what ye reap, and I shall harness it to your benefit. Then I bid ye farewell, and safe travels.
No purchases to be made today, I see. I just hope the shopkeeper understands.
The Arisen is ever prudent in the application of coin. Seem to have a ride without issue, but are we safe here?
What has become of the world? Would that there was someone who could explain this madness.
Come to think of it, did not Seraphaeus speak of releasing the world from its bonds in the Seafloor Shrine?
If this is indeed the world unbound, then perhaps we ought to seek out his wisdom.
Are the new recruits battle ready?
Now, what could this mean?
Ah, now here's a surprise.
A splendid discovery. Interesting. I shall have to inform my own master of this.
Your pawn is nowhere to be seen, Master. But where would a pawn possibly go, leaving their own master behind?
Ah, Arisen. You yet live. I suspected as much, given that your pawn still remains. One might hypothesize that your pawn is sustained by your vital essence. Or perhaps something more. In any case, we ought to apprise one another of the situation. Is there aught you would know? Ah, yes. I trust it has not escaped your notice that the end of days is upon us. After you vanished, together with the Red Dragon, the seas rose to swallow the skies. 'Twas perhaps a month from that evil day when a new calamity befell us. A host of dragons descended from the skies and fell upon the land with fang and claw. Luz, the Oracle, called upon me ere you arrived. As she tells it, Melv and its environs have already fallen prey to the beasts. Tis surely only a matter of time before the rest of the kingdom follows suit. I found the poor creature collapsed by the wayside near Batal. Recognizing your pawn, I decided to take the ailing thing into my custody. I thought it possible that the Arisen's pawn might hold the key to making sense of all this madness. Alas, try what I might, your pawn will not wake. Mayhap you will succeed where I could not. The pawn is, after all, yours to command. Indeed, then I shall take my turn. In your absence, I had hoped your pawn might yield me some information, but as you have returned, I would hear the truth from your lips. Tell me, Arisen, what became of you this past month? So, following your plunge into the sea on the dragon's back, some mysterious presence reached out to you. Could that have been the World Forged? Yet why would such a being linger in those fathomless depths? I can only speculate. And speculate I shall. This ought to prove a fruitful avenue of investigation. For that, I thank you. Now, if you can find a way to end this interminable slumber, your pawn is, of course, free to rejoin you.
Oh, Master! How long I've slept? Far too long, it seems. But worry not. Now that I am awake, I shall follow wherever you lead.
Whatever our squabbles may have been, I trust you understand that setting this world to rights takes precedence.
So you're here, are you? Now that I think of it, I do seem to recall Lord Phasus lamenting that he'd be reduced to aiding you. But it matters not. Both he and I are too rushed off our feet to care for such trivialities. We seek to devise some means of forestalling these dragons' attacks from above, you see. If you've an interest in helping us fight this battle, perhaps you will join us on Volcanic Island. Tis all the same, either way. This world needs no Arisen to save it. Such is Lord Phasus's creed and mine.
Then I shall remain by your side. The month I spent with Lord Phasus was a queer experience indeed. Though my mind was perpetually unclear, I always felt your presence, Master. I cannot explain it. Mayhap 'twas made possible by the bond we share.
'Twas an ordeal indeed, and there is much for us to ponder. But for now, we must find a means to forge ahead.
Thank you.
You saw the sky fall, I trust. I doubt you could have missed it. And wherever the sky falls, a dragon soon appears to lay waste to the land. Or so I had assumed, after what befell Melv. Yet aught here appears to be different. Has our ruin been forestalled, or merely postponed? I must examine that creature. It may well be the key to unraveling the origins of this cataclysm.
The path through this rock has been sealed to us. There's naught for it but to search for an alternate... Many paths are close to us now, on account of the dragon's descent, no doubt. But we must find a way to reach it.
Confound this obstruction! But I suppose I ought to have expected this. Answers were ne'er so easily won. Monsters! Summoned by that beast, no doubt.
Make it quick.
That's not happening.
This is my head.
You won't need a healing. Allow me.
Wait a moment.
It seems this is the only way forward. Up we go.
Principles unproven as dust on the wind.
Fine welcome indeed. I can only hope that the worst is now behind us.
Principles unproven are as dust on the wind.
fell powers are twice as terrible in the flesh. There it is. The dragon at the heart of all this destruction. We might have learned. Never mind. You've your charge, 'tis true, and the fiends appear to be falling back. But I trust you won't object if I take a sample of its remains. After all, your role is to save this world, and mine is to pursue its secrets. Go, do what you must. I will remain here and continue my work. Someday soon, I will lay bare the truth of this world. And on that day, I will slip the yoke of this broken order that rules us all.
Never did I imagine such a dragon could exist. 'Tis a glad thing we felled it, whatever 'twas.